Hey friends, welcome to our lesson this morning. I'm out here atop a mountain, right? Giant's Head Mountain specifically, because it was on a mountaintop like this where Jesus left his first followers, and yet they still had hope. Hope that he would come back, and hope that God was with them always. But I want you to think for a moment as we get started today. We're going to talk about hope, but I want you to think about some of the things that you're hopeful for. It's the start of a new school year. Maybe during the summer, you were hopeful that you would get a certain teacher or that a certain friend would be in your class. It was just my son's birthday, and he was hopeful for all kinds of things for it. I know what he was hopeful for because when I looked at my Amazon browsing history, the things I looked at, it was full of things that he had scrolled through, things he was hopeful for, and he would have been happy with any of them, but he was super hopeful for all kinds of things. You know, actually, Christmas is just 3 months away. Maybe you're already got a list going. There's already some things that you're hopeful for at Christmas. I remember as a kid that about this time of year, in the fall, we would get something called the Sears Wish Book. They didn't quite call it the Hope Book, it was the Wish Book, right? And we would go through it as kids, all right? It was all pages, super thick, of all sorts of things that you could get in the store. Or if you didn't live near one, you could order online and have mailed to you, right? And so we would spend weeks going through and circling things, and some of them were outlandish. We knew there wasn't a chance we would get them, but we were still a little bit hopeful. And then there's all sorts of, you know, more reasonable things, like a new Lego set or a Nintendo game or like this like super cool Nerf gun that just shot bulls like crazy, right? Things like that we'd be hopeful for, and there'd be a much bigger chance of getting them. And what always happened though when the things we're hoped for don't come through? Well, it can leave us disappointed, right? And disappointed can lead to sadness, and sometimes we can get stuck in that. But as Christians, as followers of Jesus, we're to be marked by three pillars, right? Faith, hope, and love is one of the things that Paul says in one of his letters. And faith, because we believe that Jesus made it possible for us to have a relationship with God. And hope, we're going to talk about today. But love is our response to others, right? Hope may be what gets us up in the morning and keeps us going. And love is our response to the world around us and our people because we have faith in Jesus and hope in Jesus. And so we get to share the love of Jesus with others. But about that hope, we've been looking this month at Paul's letter, or two letters actually, to his friends in Thessalonica. And we looked last week at how he had some lessons for them, right? Some instructions. Well, this week we want to look about three things that he offered as hope for them. And the first of those is, as a point of hope, is that God sees us. If we go all the way back to the Old Testament, to Genesis, there's the account of a man named Abraham. And Abraham, he had a huge household, lots of stuff, but there was a woman in his camp named Hagar, and she had a son named Ishmael, and they got expelled from the camp. They got kicked out, and they were out in the wilderness, in the desert, and she thought they were going to die. She thought they were going to starve to death, die of dehydration out there, and she was stuck in pain and despair, and God showed up, and he met them in the wilderness and said, "I see you, I hear you," and that's how she began to know God. She knew him as the one who sees the pain, sees the despair. And so just as Hagar knew God as the one who sees, so can we. And we can have hope because God sees us. We can also have hope because God cares for us. That was the second point that Paul made, that God cares about you and he cares about me. Jesus talks about in a few places, but especially in Matthew 6, about how God takes care of his creation. He uses the example of birds, right? Birds that fly all over the place, and they have their needs met by God. And then Jesus says, God cares about you even more than the birds that he created, that he cares for. We can have hope and confidence that God cares about us because he cares for his creation. So we have hope because God cares for us. We also can have hope because God is with us. God is with us through his Spirit, right? So we have in Acts this real dramatic account of God's Spirit coming and filling the first followers of Jesus. You might not have something so dramatic happen in your life, but we still have God's Spirit, the same Spirit, with us, guiding us, helping us understand how we should live and what we should do with our lives and how we can love others, how we can pray, how we can relate to God. We have God with us, so we can have hope because God is with us. Now you might be thinking, hey, that's talked about in the Bible, and you know that's true for the people back then, but what about now? I mean, this is 2,000 or more years later. What about us? Well, we can still be confident in those things, and we can still have hope in those things because God doesn't change. The Bible talks about how God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And so because He doesn't change, we can have hope in them. You and I, we change constantly, right? We might change our hairstyles. We might change our preferences. Like, you might not like mushrooms today, but you might very well like them down the road in years to come. Or we change all sorts of things. I mean, hopefully, we change our underwear every day, right? We change. When you're young, you grow taller. You grow more hair. You grow new smells. Well, even us old guys, I mean, we don't grow taller, but we grow shorter. We get gray hair or thinner hair, and well, the smells are just different, right? We grow, we change constantly, but not God. He doesn't change. And that's what I want to leave us with on this mountaintop today, friends, that you can be filled with hope. That's my prayer for you this week, is that you would be filled with hope because God sees you, God cares about you, and God is with you. And especially, He doesn't change. You can hope in all of those things today. And so let me leave you with that, friends. Thanks for spending a few minutes with us today atop a beautiful mountain. And have a great week.